On the agenda tonight, we're going back to mid-2020. We're going to be taking a look at Alanis Morissette, and she's going to be performing Ablaze. Hello, Phil here from Wings of Pegasus, and welcome to another analysis video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. So, this performance is coming from The Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon, and I think it was during lockdown because a lot of musicians during this time, when they're on TV shows, had to do performances from home, and that's exactly what we get here. So, we'll get everybody up on screen. We might watch it the whole way through, or I might jump into it, depending on how I'm feeling. So, if you want to watch it the whole way through without me interrupting it, there's going to be a link in the description below, as always. But let's get into the performance.
Let's not kick that blanket.
First thing that you'll notice is some separation from each other. Yes, it's a lie we've been believing since time immemorial. There was an apple, there was a snake, there was division. There was a split, there was a conflict in the fabric of life.
Is it too loud?
It's okay.
Okay.
One became two, and everyone was out for themselves. Everyone was pitted against each other.
Singing.
Keep going.
Well, you can stay.
I can stop?
Yes.
Okay, thanks.
And there we have it. What I love about this performance is that with other videos that I look at, it is undoubtedly live, the performance that we're looking at, and this goes for other videos, and there'll always be someone in the comment section who says, why do you feature a lip-synced video? And this is about as clearly live as you're ever going to get because of the fact that Alanis has got her daughter next to her also making noises between phrases, and you can't cut that out of an audio file when there are two voices going on at the same time and also the laughing. So it's great that we just get a totally live take, but it also shows how at ease Alanis is when she's singing. And all of the different registers that she goes through with her voice, I'm talking about hitting notes in chest voice, but then flipping up into head voice, and then having a head voice that has a little bit more air in the sound. Also, we're going to be jumping into it in a little bit of depth, just analyzing how she gets these sounds with her voice, because there is yodeling in there as well, but you won't notice it because she's so effective with her technique. You're just hearing the emotion of the vocal rather than the technique of the vocal. But that's the point, that all of the technique that she goes through, it seems to be so natural for her. I mean, sitting down, holding her daughter as well, you would hear on lots of vocal coach videos that when you sit down, you lose maybe a quarter or more of your support breath-wise when you're talking about your diaphragm and your breathing. But here, I'm not sure how much it takes out of you when you're holding probably quite a heavy child. Doesn't look like her daughter is really, really young. I mean, I've got nephews that are, well, 5 years of age, a little bit older than that, and two of them are seven, almost eight. But they're not light. So she's holding a kid in one arm and sitting down and still giving such a great vocal and really accurate pitch-wise, but also applying the dynamics to her singing. Another thing that Alanis has that's really subtle that's in there is her use of vibrato, and you can hear it when she's holding on notes for any length of time. She'll just throw it in there a little bit more deliberately, but pretty much the rest of her phrases are pretty straight, and there's a really subtle vibrato in there. We're not talking about a wide vibrato like classical music or musical theatre. It's just in there if you listen out for it. Another thing that I want to point out is the way that she uses her dynamic range within her voice, going from quiet and then loud again, but using her vocal registers in order to do that. So what we're going to have a listen to here is the way that she flips up into a really light head voice sound, but then is hitting notes within the same range afterwards in her chest voice. And look out for her mic technique, because even though she's sitting down and she's holding her daughter, she's still wary of the overall sound, being a professional and knowing that if she's just going to be blasting chest voice into the mic at the same range that she's hitting a very light head voice, it's going to boom and it's just going to sound too loud for that particular phrase. So you'll see this throughout the performance. When she just leans into her chest voice a little bit more and hits the notes higher in her range, she moves her head away and away from the mic because of the change in volume when compared to those lighter, more airy tones. But let's have a little listen to it.
When you reach out, I am here, head or high water.
So this first phrase where we've got there's a lot of breath in there. Hello, high water, hello, high water. Obviously, I'm not a female, but just hitting the same notes that Alanis is there. In a very light head voice kind of sound, you can hear that when I'm going, hello, high water. It's very light in tone, and I'm not using chest voice, but then this next phrase.
This nest is never going away.
Just on going there, she throws her head back to get away from the mic because she's using her chest voice now. So when she says, this nest is never going away, that going, just accessing chest voice, is a totally different sound. The vocal cords are now coming together, being really tightly pressed together, and just adding a little bit more support from the diaphragm, pushing into that sound rather than letting the air go through the vocal cords to get that same note, which is what we had previously. I'm just going to get the piano up on screen so you guys can see the range that Alanis is singing in here. And pretty much in the chorus and the high note throughout the song is going to be the C5, so right in the middle of the soprano range. And just for guys, I leave the high C in there, the C5, because that's pretty much where most guys would max out, at the top of that tenor range. Technically, the tenor range is listed as ending at A4 for guys, but that C5 you do hear referred to a lot in male vocals, and especially the kind of music that I'm into, hard rock, and guys singing up and around, you know, G4, A4, B4, and C5. But here, with the female ranges, you can see mid to top range of the mezzo-soprano, and with the contralto range, during the verses here, we will be going pretty much an octave below this C5, so down to the C4, and we've got all of this range, and when you start adding this range together with that dynamic appreciation that Alanis has, it just gives so much depth to the vocal. At some points in this song, she does push into that chest voice to get a slightly more aggressive sound, but she's still relaxed. She's not missing notes because she can't quite reach them. She's doing it intentionally because it gives a slightly different emotion and expression to the voice and the sound when she does that. But what I want to show you guys here is an indication of how relaxed her voice is, because with the voice, you have vocal breaks in there. Sometimes the voice will flip up into a head voice when it's really relaxed. And Alanis here, I'm just going to show you guys a part of her vocal, and you're going to have to take my word for it. This is part of the video, and you'll be able to see it when I play through. But we're going to be listening to this in detail, because Alanis's voice is so relaxed, she yodels, but you don't notice this when she's performing because it's so natural and it's so fast. So to demonstrate this, what I've done is reduce the speed of the video to 0.25% of the normal playback speed, so you can hear the yodels when they happen. So let's have a listen, and hopefully you'll be able to spot it. So hopefully you can hear where Alanis's voice is singing a note, and then it flips up into her head voice like a yodel, and then comes down again, and then it flips up again, and it's really fast. So you can hear those two notes. Hopefully, I'm just going to take it back to see if we can hear that again. That, it goes all the way up there. But it's just because her vocal cords are relaxed. And this is right on that point of when I've mentioned about vocalists in the past having that cry to their voice, because their vocal cords are so relaxed, they're just breaking apart almost to the point of having that vocal fry sound in there. This is exactly the same kind of approach, where the voice is crying and it's just jumping from a more chest voice register into the head voice. But it's amazing to hear that extra note just flip up. Let's have a listen to the second phrase. You can hear that we have a note that then changes to a lot higher note. So it's going, and it kind of goes up there, but it's so fast you don't notice that that top note is really coming in there. So now we'll have a listen to it at full speed, and now that we know what we're looking for, hopefully you'll be able to hear the yodeling in there that you might not have been aware of before. And there it was. So blink and you'll miss it, but it's just an indication of great vocal technique, being that relaxed to just allow that voice to go where it wants to, and just to lean into the sound a little bit more when she wants to connect her vocal cords back to the note that she was originally on. And that's pretty much what's happening here, is that Alanis is singing a note, leaning into it a little bit in terms of applying a little bit of pressure to a diaphragm and bringing those vocal cords together, but then she's just alleviating the pressure a little bit and allowing her voice to just flip up to where it wants to go before applying a little bit more pressure to get back to the note that she was originally singing. And it sounds so cool. It's just one of those things that for some reason when you're listening to it and you're not analyzing it, it just hits a chord and you connect with that sound. And it's great to hear a vocalist, especially in this kind of situation where it is so relaxed and so off the cuff in terms of a vocal performance, not doing multiple takes. But it's great to see a performance like this, just the nature of it, considering that it's on the Tonight Show as well, such a well-watched show. And during the lockdown situation, music is something that can bring everybody together. And this is a performance that really does encapsulate that, considering that we've got different generations just getting together to enjoy a performance and the band getting together as well. I will get the guitar out just in case you guys want to learn how to play this on the guitar, but it's pretty straightforward. So just quickly going through the chords, we've got the G, the C at 9, the technically E minor 7th over to the D sus 4, and I've got a cap on the first fret, by the way, as you can see, so I'll refer to the shapes as I just did there, just calling them the shapes that you'll know, G, C at 9, etc., and call the frets 1, 2, and 3. So when I've got my little finger and third finger on that high E string and B string, I'm keeping them on that third fret for the whole progression there. So when we're going through the picking, we're going E string, D string, and then we skip over to the B and come back to the G. So we've got that pattern. And then we go over with the second finger and we're taking off that first finger to leave that D string open. And then we just go down to the second fret over to the D, where now we pick the D string, the G, the high E, and down to the B, like that. So just follow that pattern and you'll be fine. And so on and so forth. The only change that we get in the chorus is that we go down to an E minor seventh shape. So when we're going through and we start the chorus in exactly the same way with this progression that we just had, same picking, actually through twice. And now we're into, I think we've still got that little skip over, so we go from the E to then the E, kind of like that. It could be to the A string, but I'm skipping over to the D, over to the D sus 2, over to the C add 9, and there's a little rest there. And there's that little part there. We get into the picking for the verse again. Just jumping into the middle A, or the bridge as it's also called. We're now half time. We've got this D, A minor 7th, C, G, D again, A minor 7th. And we've got that kind of thing. You can follow the bass like I did there, going from that C down to the B, and then let go of that third finger to let that D string ring out. Going then over to the D. So those are, I believe, all the chords for the song if you want to try and play along with it as well. But such a unique performance. It's not one of those that you see all the time with the artist having their child in the room and the child just being free to talk over the microphone and cover the artist's mouth, but I love that about this performance. It's got such an endearing quality to it. It's so rare, but also you get to appreciate the relationship between mother and daughter, and you get to appreciate the level that Alanis is at vocally, where she can supply this kind of vocal in this kind of situation, being so relaxed with that delivery as well, and still be on pitch and have such great dynamic range and control in her voice. But thank you guys so much for suggesting this video for me to take a look at, and keep the suggestions coming in the comments below. Let me know what you guys think, and if you did enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you guys at the next one. Rock!